Okay, am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's have a restart.
Yes, sir.
Well, friends, thank you for welcome once again. So what we are learning that we'll be starting that GST, we'll be starting the subject indirect tax in the context we are understanding what are the websites that we need to familiarize ourselves with. I told you three websites through which we'll be able to we'll be collecting our reading material from those websites. One is CBIC website. Second one is GST website, GST portal in fact. And third one is our ICAE website, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India website. We'll be seeing that. So the second website I was showing you, in fact, once again I'm trying to share the screen with you. Give me a moment. Are you seeing it now? Are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You can see the website.
So this is called as the GST portal. First website I told you, CBIC website. I told you that you please download the GST book from that website. I'll show you how that book looks like. Just a minute. I'll be showing you that thing also. This is GST book. Are you seeing it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This book can be downloaded. Can go through entire act is here. You can go through this. Okay, this is one thing I told you. Okay, and one more website. I'll be taking you to that website also. Let us see. So as you can see, this website is gst.gov.in, right? Here all services, that means all the practical things we'll be learning through this website. That is, first of all, let us say registration process. You would definitely like to learn the registration process, right? I'll be showing you how one person needs to register, how one person will be able to get himself registered through this website, registration. Okay, new registration, etc. will be learning here. Then how GST payments can be made. Okay, and other user related services, refund issues, e-way bill, all these things will be learning. Right, and again, filing of the returns, everything will be learning. Practically, we'll be seeing it through this website. Okay, this is for all our practical purpose. Of course, GST Act and etc. also available here. You can download from here also. If you click here, here is a link, download applying to taxpayers. I'll show you. You can find out there are some links through which you can download GST laws. Okay, here is the link, GST law. various GST acts are there. Let us say CBIC. This is a central act, and all other laws can be downloaded from this website also. Fine. I'm taking you to one more website. As I told you, this is, you see what I'm typing here. What is this website? Are you seeing it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This is which website? Some of you please speak. This is the website of, as you can see,
ICAI,
Institute of Chartered Accountants. Right. So why I'm taking you to this website, that please visit here and go here. You see here, there is a link students, right? So inside students, you can find one more link, Board of Studies Knowledge Portal, right? Board of Studies Knowledge Portal. Inside that, you can find various courses are there. So we'll go here, intermediate course. Inside that intermediate course, you can find a paper, taxation. And within that taxation paper, you can find a link, study material. And in that study material, here is the study material for indirect taxes. And these are the study material which will be useful for us. One is that GST book that will be useful for us, because that is in fact the where act. If any time if you want to refer to the act, then we will refer to that book. And for study purpose, we can refer to these study materials. Chapter 1, Chapter 2, Chapter 3, Chapter 4, Chapter 5. And our plan is to cover the entire thing which is there in this syllabus. But we will be covering it in a different order. We may not go in the same order in which it is written here. Let us say some basic things we will be understanding. Then we may try to understand the registration process. Like this. So we may not maintain this order, but we are definitely going to learn all this thing. Got some idea where from we will be getting reading material? Yes or no? Can you collect your reading
material?
So two sources I told you. Number one is CBIC. Please download the GST book. It is available there. Second one is study material from ICAI's Board of Studies portal. Here also you can get your study material. If you try to do it, in case for some reason you are unable to do it, let me know. I'll be sending you those materials. But I expect you yourself should do it so that you will be able to familiarize yourself with the website. So there may be
many. Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, please.
So for the study material from ICAI website, do you need to download all the modules?
Yeah, all the modules.
Till chapter 10.
Yeah, all the modules.
Okay, sir.
We are also planning to cover everything. But as I told you, we'll be covering everything in a different order. We may not follow this same sequence, but in different order, we'll be covering everything.
Right, sir.
Okay. And in addition to that, I expect you to visit to other two websites also, because side by side, you want to see the practical things also. So only when you will be familiarizing yourself with this websites, then only learning will be effective. Are you getting me? Suppose I'm explaining you chapter 7 registration process. I can tell you the process, but we are also expecting at the same time, you should know how to do practical registration. That you have to do through this GST portal. Fine. Let us say we are learning how to make GST payment. But at the same time, you should be able to do how to pay GST. So these processes are there, or we have to complete these processes for our training process through that website. So please visit to all these websites. Okay, is it clear up to this?
Yes, sir.
Well, now, okay, one more thing I will tell you. when you are seeing, you see one chat box is appearing before you. So during the class, I expect that all of you, when you are attending the classes, just drop your roll number in this chat box. Okay, only write your roll number. Don't do any kind of private chat by using this chat box. We have different methods of taking attendance, but as a cross check, I am telling you, please write your roll numbers in the chat box. That will be cross checked with your attendance record. As I told you, attendance can be taken at any moment. Any moment we will be taking attendance automatically. And your presence or absence will be recorded like this. First, that's like the way you are doing, just like that. I want that if you are attending the classes, every class, just drop your roll number there in your chat box. Well, now friends, we'll start the subject now. I was trying to create a platform. Once again, I am sharing the screen with you. Is it visible to you now? I had told you about this disclaimer. I had already shown you what is the content, what we are going to study in our classes. Over 50 classes, all these things we are going to learn. I had explained you what is our evaluation mechanism, what is the process of evaluating you. And I had showed you how to visit to these websites, where from you can download your ebook. And also I had shown you another website. By using this website, you will be able to do the practicals. You will be learning the practical things like filing of the return, payment of goods and services tax, etc. You'll be learning through this website. I also showed you one more website. You can visit here to the link students. Inside that, you can find one more link, Board of Studies Knowledge Portal, through which you can download the study materials. All these things are freely downloadable and they are updated things. So we will be using all these materials as our reading material, right? We need not buy any book, but we'll be these reading materials will be very good for us, and that will be very relevant for our subject. Okay, now coming to subject, first I'm showing you something. Are you able to see the screen? Now tell me what you are seeing on the screen. Now we are starting the subject now. What you are seeing, can you explain what is this?
Sir, it's an Amazon invoice.
Amazon invoice. Right. Yes, so it gives us some idea. Let us read it very carefully. First, you see. What is written here? Just read. Are you able to see the cursor? Are you able to see the cursor?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is written here?
Sold by.
Sir, sold by, sir. It's
sold by. Right, sold by. Sold by means what it shows, this is the seller's address. This kind of invoices we always see in our day-to-day life. Every day we see this kind of invoices, isn't it now? Whenever you buy something, whether you buy a product or avail some services, so you get invoices like this. So in an invoices, if you see a particular person, there is the detail of the supplier who is selling you. In this case, it is a seller. Okay? Right? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So any invoice you find in particular person, definitely there will be some seller's information. Okay, so earlier when you were having VAT, value added taxes, we are calling this person as seller. Okay, that's why it is written sold by. But today under GST, we will not be calling that person as a seller. Okay, loosely you may call that person as seller, but here sales word is not there, we'll be calling that person as supplier. Because GST uses another term which is called the supplier. When you use the term sale, it refers to a particular commodity. Is it not? It's a goods or commodity are sold. But GST covers both goods as well as services. Suppose an advocate is providing a service or a chartered accountant is providing a service, he will be also raising a GST invoice. This invoice is called as a tax invoice. Okay, are you seeing it? What is it in here? This is called tax invoice, right? For GST purpose, this kind of invoices only are valid. And it will be containing suppliers' detail. These are the suppliers, right? This person is a supplier. Okay. Okay, please unmute and speak.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please keep on interacting. And you see the other side, it shows who is receiving that product. That detail is also there. Okay, shipping detail, all these things are there. You can find one invoice number. Are you finding it? And here you can find GST registration number is the supplier. It's the GST registration number. Now please tell me how many digits are there in GST registration number. Can you count it? Who can tell me?
15.
So everybody has a GST registration number 15. Let us have some basic idea about GST. Right, 15. Now, can you see this is what above that what is written PAN? Right. So you have studied income tax. You must be knowing how many digits are there in PAN. How many digits are there? Without counting, can you tell me? How many digits?
10.
10. Okay. Now, can you find all these digits here in GST registration number? All these things. AAQCS 4259Q. Is it there? Are you finding?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this gives us a basic idea that you see GST registration number or GSTN is linked to PAN. Is it done? You see, PAN number is also embedded in the GST number. Okay. Some of you might be knowing it. Some of you, it might be a new concept. So every GST invoice must be having supplier's detail, recipient's detail. There should be a number and there should be a GST number of the supplier. Only when this number is there, then only that person can charge GST. When this person has billed the recipient, he has included GST. Right? Price is this much, net amount is this much, plus GST is this much. Total comes to here. Only when this registration number is there, this person can charge GST. If this number is not there, that person doesn't have any right to charge GST. If someone is charging you GST and you find an invoice, GST number is not there, that means he's doing a kind of fraud. He's collecting GST from you, but he's not paying it to government. So ensure, whenever someone is charging you GST, ensure that he is a registered person. That will know only when his registration number is displayed in the invoice. Okay? Now tell me, here you see, what is the base price, can you tell me, in this bill? What is the net amount, what is written here? Who can tell me? Aditi, can you say?
Sir, 381.36.
Yeah, this is the net amount. Okay, but on that, how much is added as GST?
Sixty-eight point six four.
Okay. What is the rate of tax?
18%.
18%. So on this 18%, we will be learning in most of the cases. We find just 18% rate is applicable. We will be learning different rates are also there, but most of the cases you'll find 18%. So 18% is collected by way of GST, and this is, there are different kind of GST. This is a particular kind of GST. What is written here? Can you see it? Which GST?
IGST, sir.
IGST. Okay. What is IGST? We'll be learning after some time. So this is one kind of GST which is called as the IGST. Right? There will be other GSTs are also there, like SGST, CGST. Any one of you knows what is IGST, what is CGST, what is SGST? Who can tell me? If somebody knows it at all. Otherwise, I'll be explaining. So there are three kinds of GSTs we see, or four kinds of GSTs we see. One is CGST, one is SGST, one is IGST. And one more kind of GST is also there, that is called as UTGST. And in different situations, in different bills, you will find different kind of GSTs. Okay. Now think over it. What is IGST? I'll be telling you after some time. And you see, invoice should have a date. So that should be a date. That should be a base amount, net amount, then tax rate, then how much is added, then finally, how much money is to be paid. This is how normal a bill looks like, IGST bill. I'm showing you one more bill. Here you see one more tax invoice. Here also you see written tax invoice. Can you see it? You see suppliers details are here. Buyers details are here. In the previous bill you see supplier was having GST registration number. Buyer was not having GST registration number. Buyer was a person. Individual is not registered for GST. Are you getting? This is a kind of invoice. Supplier were having GST registration number. Okay, but buyer registration numbers are not here because buyer is not a registered person. Okay, are you with me? And this is, you see, another kind of invoice. Supplier is having registration number. Buyer is also having registration number. First case, we'll be calling it as the B2C, this case. That means registration number is said, we'll say this is a business and this person is a customer or consumer. He is consuming. He is not doing any kind of business. Right? You see, this is a company which is selling a particular individual. We can call it as a B2C, business to customer invoice. Are you with me? Understood what is B2C invoice?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Can you distinguish what is B2C invoice? How can you distinguish? How can you distinguish? How can you find out that? How can you conclude that this is a B2C invoice? Sairaj, can you speak?
Sir, the invoice wherein the GST number of the customer, of the buyer or the customer is being present, then it is the B2C.
Customers is present, it is B2C.
Sir, only buyers.
Not buyers. Suppliers GSTN will be there.
Sir, sorry, but sir.
Yes,
sir,
buyers supplier. GSTN is supplier. Not there. Right? That you have to see.
Yes, sir.
Then it is B2C. Right? B2C. That means one supplier, one consumer. Okay. And we'll be learning subsequently, since it's a B2C, this person cannot take input credit. What is input credit? I'll be explaining you subsequently. But just have an idea. With this kind of invoice, you cannot take input credit. Because you are the consumer, you have to bear the ultimate consequence of this GST. That means this much of money which you are paying, you have to bear its consequences. You cannot transfer it to somebody else. Because it's a B2C invoice. But this invoice you see, this person is supplying. He's a supplier. Can you see this GSTN? Here also you see 21AABCD. Can you read it? And here you see recipient is also another farmer. This is their GSTN. This is GSTN. This is GSTN. This kind of invoices are called as what? What I will call it? If first one is B2C, this one is what should I call it? B2B. We'll call it as a B2B or business to business invoice. okay, here this person who is getting this kind of invoice, he can take credit, input credit will take. Understood? Now, are you understanding the importance of this invoice? This piece of paper is important because this person, what this person has purchased, it has purchased one Tally ERP package, ERP 9 package. Two numbers of Tally ERP. It has purchased, total amount is 32,203, but this person has paid two different kind of GST. Can you see what kind of GST he is paying? Can you read it out?
GST.
Which GST is?
CGST and SGST.
Earlier,
the central GST and
state GST. One is central GST, second is state GST. And if you see here also, both taken together is also 18%. Okay, so central GST is 9%, SGST is 9%. So 9, 9 taken together are again 18%. Okay, and why it is CGST and SGST? We need to understand this invoice now. This important concept we will be understanding. Okay, concept is here. You see, what is the GST in GST in of this person? Can you read it? Some of you please read it. Can you read it? GST in of supplier, is it readable? Shweta, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Can you read suppliers? I am looking for suppliers GST. In this invoice, find out and tell me what is the GST in of supplier. Who is supplier? Can you tell me the supplier's name?
Sir,
which one?
The first one will be
Tristar Software. Is it? I think
yes.
Tristar Software and Solution is the supplier. You see, yes, GSTN is 21AABCT5434D1ZW.
Yes, sir.
And you see, it starts with the code 21. And 21 is the state code for Odisha. Code is 21. Meaning, the supplier is from state Odisha. The moment you find GSTN start with 21, that means supplier is located as Odisha. And the recipient, you see, the receiver also is. This is his GSTN. It also starts with the code 21. Here it is also written state code 21. It's a B2B invoice. That means it is from Odisha to Odisha. Within Odisha. You can say this is an intrastate supply. If it is an intrastate supply, then the same 18% will be distributed like this. Half of it will be collected in the form of CGST. Half of it will be collected in the form of SGST. Are you getting? Therefore, CGST is 9%, SGST is 9% because this is intrastate within the state. And all other information will also be there. Invoice number, invoice date. Okay. So breakup of money. What is the base price? What is the GST? What is the total amount? You see, entire breakup is here. Okay, you see, central tax 9%. Can you see? State tax 9%. Okay. Are you seeing it? Okay. Is it okay for you? Can anyone of you respond?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you understood in which situation CGST, in which situation IGST will be levied. Here IGST. Why it is IGST? Because
different state, sir.
Different state. You see, the recipient is located in Odisha, but supplier is at Karnataka. Supplier's code starts from 29. Had it been 21, that means both of them are located in one state. You see, 29. That means this is an interstate supply. Whereas this one is an intrastate supply. This is within state or intrastate. Previous is that among different, between two different states or interstate supply. Fine. I am showing you one more bill, you see. Here also you see, this is customer's detail. Okay. This is a customer's detail. Where customer is located? Can you read it here?
Bangalore,
Karnataka.
Bangalore, Karnataka. That's why you see the GSTN starts with 29 is the state code. And where supplier is located, suppliers GSTN, you see?
Sir, Odisha.
Odisha. So it is interstate or intrastate bill. What kind of invoice?
Interstate.
This further we should charge IGST or SGST or CGST.
IGST.
Since IGST. It is an interstate, you see, IGST is collected and the entire money is a central government, central tax. IGST 18%. Had it been an intrastate, then we could have collected 9% under CGST, 9% under SGST. Understood? Okay. Anyone who is collecting any money under GST, that person must have a GST registration number. Without this, one cannot collect GST. Okay, understood up to this? Yes or no? Cyrus, can you respond?
Yes, sir.
Understood. I am showing you one more invoice. This is one more invoice. You see, what is, tell me where customer is located.
Odisha.
And where supplier is located?
Same, sir, Odisha.
How you know that?
Sir, the GST number starts with 21.
21? Here also it is 21. Yes. Okay. You can Google it and find out various state codes. You can easily understand. And that is, if that is so, then this is an interstate or intrastate supply. What kind of supply is it?
Intrastate.
Then should I collect IGST or SGST or CGST or all of them?
So CGST and SGST. CGST and SGST.
No, IGST. How much?
So 9% CGST and 9% SGST.
Very good. Now I think any kind of GST invoice at least you can understand without knowing much about law also. Whenever you get a bill, first see that the person who is collecting actually is entitled to collect that money or not. Right? I think this part at least you can verify, you can be sure that the GST money you have paid under proper head and to proper person. Suppose someone is giving a bill like this, but you find that person doesn't have this GST number. GSTN is not there. Should you pay GST to that person? Should you pay? Yes or no? Yes or no? Who can answer? Aditi, can you say? If someone is giving a bill like this but without GST?
No, sir, we can't pay.
I can't is different. You should not pay. If this is the bill, then you should say, I will not pay you 59,000. I will be paying you 50,000 because you are not authorized to collect GST. You do not have any GST registration number. Your bill is okay, but I will be paying you only 50,000 rupees because these two things you are not supposed to collect from me because you don't have GST.
So GST.
Because why he is collecting these two amounts? Because he has to deposit it with the government. Now, without this number, he cannot deposit. So if he is collecting it in illegal manner. Okay? Understood these GST billing concepts?
Yes, sir.
Now, yes, finally, sir. Okay, this is how different kind of bills we issue. Right? This is how in different situation, depending upon the supplier's location, depending upon the recipient's location, we issue different kind of bill. And different rates are also applicable. That also depends upon the kind of goods we are supplying and what kind of services we are providing. So a particular rate will be applicable. So as per that rate, whether GST, CGST, SGST or UPGST or IGST will be collected. And accordingly, that will be deposited with government. I'll be showing you how it will be deposited, through which process we'll be depositing this GST. Maybe next class I'll be showing you that thing. Okay. So maybe after 15 minutes, we'll be having our second class. I will stop here right now. Again, we'll catch up at 3:45. Okay. Do you have any query up to this? Do you have any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Let us catch up at 3:45. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.